Welcome to KY Talks. I am Sonal Ambedkar, your host for this interview. Moya Entrepreneur is a digital platform where we talk to several entrepreneurs to tell us why they chose not to be stuck with the regular 9-to-5, but they went ahead and did something different. They went ahead and chased a passion. Today, we will be talking to the founders, co-founders of Happy People and Company, Tanvi Swali, Shreya Shiha, and Pehel Makhij. It all started at a summer camp for kids in 2019 that set the wheels in motion. They quickly moved on to organizing DIY workshops for cafes, restaurants, corporate, and then launched their DIY art kits for children and adults. They curate and host birthdays, events, workshops, and provide customized gifting solutions. With the lockdown, they redirected and steered in a slightly different direction. But one thing remained constant, their mission to spread happiness through their work. Happy People and Company is a brainchild of two driven women, Shreya and Tanvi, who are from diverse fields but share a common passion of spreading happiness through their work. And they were soon joined by Pehel. Hi, welcome Shreya, Pehel and Tanvi.
Hi.
Thank you so much.
So I'd like to give a little bit of an insight on our founders today. Shreya is a graphic designer by profession and she has also studied handbag designing from London. She's extremely passionate about art and design and strongly believes that art is a great medium of expression. Without any restrictions, it can help the young and old emote better and connect with themselves. Happy People and Company gave her a platform to share the joy of creating and curating memorable experiences. Tanvi has studied fashion designing and worked as a stylist, but very soon she discovered her passion for teaching children and decided to take ECCED. Which helped her pursue her love for working with them. She has worked as a teacher for 10 years and is also a talk therapist. Happy People and Company gave her a platform to connect with new people of various age groups and from different walks of life. And Pehel has pursued bachelor's in computer application and arts. She used to manage her own vocational training institute of finance and now takes care of the and used to take care of the consultancy for 5 years. After a career break, she joined Happy People and Company, where she got the opportunity to manage and connect with people and work with children, which she loves to do today. Amazing profile, guys.
Thank you.
So, it's so good to hear. So guys, tell me how, it started at a summer camp, but I'd like to get more insight on what exactly kickstarted Happy People and Company, and how did Shreya and Tanvi, come to that decision that we're gonna start Happy People and Company and take this forward?
So basically, you already mentioned, it started with one camp, and we got together. We were from very different walks of life.
Right.
We started this camp, and we sort of realized that we share the same passion.
Right.
And we had the same wavelengths. So we thought, and then we went on to taking art workshops at a cafe. So basically one thing led to another. And then, that's how we worked on our, vision.
Right.
We both, yes, in spite of being, from different professions,
right,
we shared the vision, right? So it quickly progressed, just from a camp. We never thought that we were going to do something like
forward,
right, this forward. But the art workshop at the corporate was a very good opportunity for us to actually start our own company and our own baby, which we always wanted to do, right?
Yeah.
But till then we didn't have an idea as to
what exactly,
where,
right?
Yeah, what exactly are we going to do? And that's how we started Happy People and Company. Tanvi can add something if she wants to.
So we started with the name Happy Us. So that became very, the name was very,
like, right, I understand.
Yeah. So everyone was like, what's this Happy Us? And then when we got after 6 months, earlier we were not like, we were like, okay, we're just starting off. We'll see how it goes. But after the corporate workshops, we realized it's going really good for us, and we have a direction. And
right,
that's where we started. We, in November 2019, we had our brand logo. We did our branding. And in December 2019, Pehel joined us when we did this carnival, which was for like 1,000 kids. And it was the first in Navi Mumbai, where we stay. It's first of its kind. So that's where Pehel joined us that point of time. And that's how Happy People Corps evolved.
Right. So Pehel, would you like to mention anything on how you like found that your passion also is in the same line with Shreya and Tanvi?
Yeah, so when I got into carnival things, so that excited me, you know, the event which I was never a part of earlier. I used to totally into consultancy, training. Right. This was something totally new and I was enjoying it.
Two different fields, diverse, totally. Right.
Yes. So it was completely fun and, you know, you're connecting with a lot of people.
Right. So apart from this being your passion, was there any other factor that worked as a motivation for you to, you know, become an entrepreneur or have something of your own? Like Treya said that you started your baby. Obviously, for an entrepreneur, whatever they start is their baby. So was there any motivation ki, oh, I want to start, or we want to start something of our own? Anything like that?
Yeah, so basically for me, it was always like I've been working like from past 10 years. So what happens is the recognition, whatever your hard work is going to a brand, right? Like a school I'm working for. So I used to do admission counseling also for them. Yes, I was the face for it. But again, the brand is theirs.
Right.
So that point of time is like, where is my growth? What am I doing in life? You know, to have that whole identity, to have that thing, the kickstart of having your own baby, the way it's said, and to nurture it, it's a different feeling.
Right.
And yeah, there was a lot of risk involved because you have to, like, you're leaving your ex-income and getting into a thing where you don't know if you're
going to get you income, leave that security of, you know, getting
the security that because,
X amount of salary at the end of every month.
Through that. And it was in the start, in the initial stage, you have to plan out because we were not getting a proper income out of it in the first year, right? So yeah, it was a thing, but I think for me and for all of us, it was like breaking your comfort zone. So we all were in our own comfort zone. They were in their own comfort zone. We decided to take that leap of faith that we want to do something. And that's where we became Happy People.
I mean, it's all about taking that one step. It's always like a big risk.
The first leap is always challenging.
Yeah, the first step. But then once you take that first step, you win half the battle. That's what they say, right? And isn't that true? I mean, from your own experience, won't you say that's true?
Yeah, and the thing is, you have to find your calling. I feel if you find your calling and then you have, you know, if you want to follow it and then you take the leap of faith, I think you half the battle is won.
Very nicely said, Shreya.
Yeah.
So my next question to you guys is, what is it that you would say gives you a sense of accomplishment? Waisa kehte hai na ki kick milti hai. A driving force that gets you going every morning. Ki, oh, yesterday I did this, today I'm going to achieve this. Today I'm going to spread this kind of joy to these set of people. So what would you say is it?
So I think like we said that our vision and our mission is to spread happiness through our work. And I think that keeps us going. Tanvi being a teacher, like she has dealt with so many kids, right? So, and actually dealing with them and teaching them something is pure joy.
Right.
And for me, it's art and spreading happiness through something that you're very passionate about and gifting. So, and for Pehel also, she shares the same vision. So I think that's what keeps us going, you know, and it gives us pure joy.
Of course.
And so much love in return. For example, whenever you're teaching and you, it's like unconditional love what you get in return. Be it gifts, you're making people happy, right? Gifts, who doesn't love gifts?
Right.
Teaching, make the children happy in a fun way.
Right.
So with teaching, and there is so much love, so obviously it's like the best
wonderful
thing, and we are and plus working with each other.
And another thing that was mentioned, that I mentioned in your introduction, was that it's about, you know, ability to emote. Art is all about the ability to emote, not just for the children but for the adults, and when that kind of emotion comes out, There's such a beautiful feeling inside that, oh, this was inside me. Oh, wow, it's on paper now, or I've done something out of it now. And it's so wonderful to see that coming from inside and out on you know, some paper or some craft object that you've done. And definitely, I mean, so many people must be getting so happy just to, you know that, oh, they're capable of doing this also.
So the word is fulfilling.
Fulfilling, yeah.
Yeah. Sonal, I would like to add one thing, what happened, like an example, what you just
yes,
said.
Please.
Like in one of our art workshops at WeWork, this guy who just came to us and told us that I was stuck with a problem in my work. And when I attended your workshop, I got this thing out of my mind and I got a solution to it.
Wow.
And the art made him feel it was like meditation for him and
right.
something where he could solve his, you know, that his problem or whatever he was facing that point of time. So art does wonders for sure.
Right. So that mental
it's
block.
It's a therapy.
Yeah. Rightly said, Pehel. Like you mentioned that. So we all sometimes face that mental block while we are working, and we just can't, you know, find that solution to that something. But then it's good to know that what you're doing, the art, making people, you know, open to how therapeutic art can be. This is another kind of, you know, awareness that wasn't there in our society. Like mental health was one thing that we weren't aware about. This is also one kind of therapy that people weren't much aware about, but you are spreading that happiness, that joy, that awareness. That's wonderful. So moving on to my next question, I would like to ask every entrepreneur or say co-founders, when they start something of their own, every journey has its sets of ups and downs and challenges, barriers they face. So how would you say that you face certain barriers or challenges, and how did you overcome them? Well, I'd like to ask you first, because you completely changed your field of what you were doing, and then you came to a new field, and it's always
totally
very
art
difficult
was something,
doing
that. Yes, art was something really new to me. I was not at all into, you know, creative. I'm not at all a creative person.
Right.
But yeah, again, I've learned a lot. And challenges, yes, it took me some time to, you know, but
catch
now,
up with them.
Yeah, like,
but yeah, of course.
Yes.
I mean, once you take that first step, then you. Okay, you get to know how to go about it. You learn. And life is all about learning, is it?
But that's the best part.
Yeah, that's the best part. So, Shreya and Tanvi, would you like to add something about the barriers that since you guys started it, Happy People and Company started with you. I'm sure you guys also must have faced certain barriers which you know, may have made you feel that, oh, can we even take this ahead? But then you must have found some solutions for it.
Yeah, so for us, for like 1 year, then the lockdown happened and we were into corporates. So switching from corporates, and then we had to find a solution to sustain in the market, right?
Right.
Like, what do we do? Yeah, we were with kids, we were doing these camps, but we were concentrating more on corporates. So to redirect that whole thing from corporates to kids, and how we came up with our camps, how conceptual art classes and stuff was a thing. That's what I was saying, that how we went from lockdown to redirecting from corporates to kids and figuring a way to sustain in the market.
Right.
Because in March, we didn't do anything at all. We just didn't work.
Right.
So in April, we realized to get going, we have to find a solution to sustain in the market. And that's where we started more camps online. We were figuring which platform, what to do, how do we go about it.
Right.
But even in that, we got like the complete month, like April and May, till the schools didn't start, we had like around 15 kids in our camps, like per, and we used to have two camps, morning, evenings.
Morning and
we
evening.
We had stopped because we didn't want to take a risk.
Right.
Yeah. So,
Like you said that even during COVID, I mean, there was a, you know, it was like something was holding us back. But then everyone figured out that there's so much more that you can do even by, you know, being locked inside your houses. This digital era that's completely, you know, kickstarted because of COVID. This has really made a lot of, you won't believe, a lot of my other, you know, people that have joined me on KYE Talks, they've told me that 2020 has actually been like a boon to them, because they figured out that they can, you know, actually work and conduct these online classes or online sessions and things like that for their work, you know, through this platform. And it's made things so much more easier for them. So it was definitely an eye-opening period, this 2020. The year that we kind of called a terrible year, but it wasn't as terrible now if you look back on it.
Correct.
So would Shreya like to add anything on the barriers part?
Barriers, I think Tanvir has pretty much summed it up. And you know, when you're beginning anything, like you leave your comfort zone. All of us are, you know, at different stages in life, you know, and looking to do something. So there is always that question, but you have to take the leap of faith and do it, you know, that you spoke about. So I think, yeah, that's pretty much it that we decided, yes. And then there are these small barriers, you know, there are these small obstacles. But the fun is, you know, to overcome those challenges. Right. That's exciting part, you know, and that's a part of your journey, and
it also motivates you and encourages you that once you overcome something, it's like, I was capable of doing this, so how much more am I capable of doing? I won't know until I try and figure it out, right?
And you get confident also,
right.
You're learning, and you're learning and evolving every day.
So my next question, please go on, Shreya.
I'm saying these barriers, I think, sort of required these obstacles, you know.
Right. To also keep you grounded and also to make you realize what all you're capable of.
Exactly.
Correct.
True. So my next question would be, what do you guys feel are the factors that would help you achieve your business aspiration? Because see, before COVID hit us, we all had certain plans and certain goals and certain aims that we had set for ourselves personally, as well as for our careers or our professions. But COVID hit us and suddenly everything had to change. We had to change our ways. So what would you say? Have factors changed, or what have you realized would be the new factors that would help you get there?
Also, one thing that I would like to say is constant support from each other, you know, because, you know, being on the same, constantly supporting and encouraging each other is very important. So when you're working
Of course.
Absolutely. It's never me or I. It's always us.
Us, right.
And we also realize and we believe in collaborations, so that, you know, encouraging each other, working with each other and growing with other people as well. That is one thing that really happy people believes in. So we will never say that it's just us or we want to limit it to us. Collaborating with others. There are so many people who are talented. So, you know, you cannot do everything. So, you know, working in that integration and growing together is something that we strongly believe in.
I mean, this collaboration of the three of you from these diverse fields have actually made you all such a wholesome group of founders, hasn't it? I mean, you each bring some skill to Happy People and Company, and that's how you're like all rounded in a way. Which is also, you know, they say that the better the team, the better the outcome, isn't it?
Because every has a different skill set,
right?
So together and making use of it actually can get you wonderful results.
Right Very nicely said. So I'd like to ask the three of you, ever since you've joined hands together and you've started on this journey of, you know, running your own venture, being entrepreneurs, an entrepreneur has to wear all hats. I mean, they can't be just the boss. They have to know everything that's going on, right? So the three of you are doing it collectively together. So how would you say has this venture or this experience changed you as a person? Each one. Pehel, would you want to start?
Yeah, as I said earlier, I was from a different background. I've learned a lot first thing. And it had made me patient also, you know. I become more patient and more, you know, I'm like open to a lot of new things. I can learn.
Right.
Yes.
I mean, opening yourself to art was in itself such a new thing that, of course, new things are going to be coming your way. Shreya, what would you say? How has it changed you?
I think confidence, you know, you build so much confidence. And I have fantastic support from Tanvi and Pehel. You know, so they are a great support system. I think that makes a very big difference. So one big change I would say is confidence in yourself. I couldn't probably be so confident about talking, you know, and here we had to continuously
talk to people, right,
and make sure that you're giving your best, right? So take something out of it. It's not just some, you know, you just don't want to do it for the heck of it.
Absolutely right.
So, definitely confidence and learning happens every day, right? So that and the excitement of, you know, building your own brand and sustaining it. Yes. So the force, the drive.
Right.
Not doing anything. Obviously, you know, there's a very big difference when you're not working or you're working and there's monotony. But this is like, you know, you have to be driven and that drive. So you realize a lot, you know, that okay, yeah, you have to be, because this is your own baby, so you have to run it. So you have to be,
and you have to nurture it like you would your actual true baby, like you guys have done it. So yeah, there's one question I would like to ask you, which I always ask moms who are also running some business. How do you manage your households and manage happy people and company? Because you can't compromise on anything. You have to be 100% here, you have to be 100% there. And that's something, that's some multitasking that only superwoman can do.
So time management is a challenge.
Right.
Totally.
Always. They say that superwoman, the term is such, but I think nobody's a superwoman like that. All of us have our, definitely you, there is a compromise somewhere where you would feel like there are guilt pangs as a mother that you feel that, oh, I'm not
giving enough time to my child.
There would be guilt pangs because like, oh my God, I'm not giving enough time to the company. Then what do I do? How do I?
Right.
One day at a time, everybody does that, you know, you manage it somehow and it's perfect. It's never going to be like the right balance. I feel there's never 100% that you can do, but you just have to give in your best and take each day as it comes.
Right,
you know?
Right. So Tanvi, yes, Pehel, please, you mentioned what you.
No, I just agreed with Shreya that what she is completely. I'm like
Tanvi, you didn't tell me what. How has this venture changed you as a person? How has this experience changed you as a person?
So I was not that patient. I think I used to just talk and be like, now I know when to talk where the diplomacy and being the patient which comes in you, and to handle like we three are very different people all together. And there are times where I have to tell them or whatever. I'm the youngest amongst them. So it's like obviously they're much more mature than me, but then I have learned so much from them, especially art, like if the intricacy, now I know what Shreya wants. I don't have to, they were like, it's not pot. We fought like crazy. We got back. We know after 10 minutes, we have to call each other again because where will we go?
Right.
So it's like that. They have taught me like the smallest thing, like her eye is like an X-ray machine. So she's taught me, I tell her, listen, this is not okay now. What do we do about that? She's like, so yeah, they have taught me a lot of patience.
Of course. And since they are a little more experienced than you, they must have also taught you how to go about life, right? That is something that we can learn from you know, people who are experienced. We obviously can't take everything from other people's experience, but we can always be, you know, more cautious listening from other people's experience. And I'm sure Shreya and Pehel must have given you some really great life tips on how to, you know, go ahead in your own life.
I think all of us do that for each other in some way, right?
Right.
Young.
So my last question to you all is, what would be a message that you would like to give our viewers? You know, like Shreya said and like Tanvi said, that it's about taking that first step. But there are so many people out there who have an innovative idea, who have something, you know, some brainstorming they've done and they have this idea. They're just too scared to take that first step. Too scared to, you know, win that half of the battle. So how would you encourage them, or what message would you like to give them that would motivate them to do it? Pehel, would you like to go? Aap Pehel karna chahoge?
I would say one has to be very consistent,
right?
Very open about it. Consistency will definitely, you know, lead you somewhere.
Right.
Yes. Yeah.
Shreya?
And you have to work hard.
Of course, yes. Rightly said. Shreya, what would you add?
Like I mentioned, I always believe from my personal experience that if you found your calling, it just makes it very easy. Right. And then you just have to believe in yourself and take it ahead.
Rightly said.
Sure, like in your head that this is what I'm passionate about, that I can wake up at 2 in the night and also
do this. Right.
And do it. I think half the battle is won. Is what I feel personally. So I think it's absolutely, you know, then believing in yourself and taking that step becomes very easy.
Easy. Right. Yeah. Tanvi, what would you like to add?
So, I feel what happens with people is, like for me also, it was the financial part. I was independent. So, to take that thing financially, if you see in a practical way, that what will happen next? How will I survive?
Right.
But I'm sure it is not that difficult if you take that step. Because if we all can do it, and we all figure a way out if we get out of our comfort zone.
Right.
So, it just, again, to take that step. Even for like 10 years, I couldn't take that step for my income. But when I took it, I found a way which was that when I got out of it, I got something, you know.
Right. Like you mentioned the comfort zone, it's like success or achievements always lie out of our comfort zone. And it's so important comfort for us zone. To, you know, step out of it. Because until then, we are always going to be just sitting and thinking and overthinking, should I do it? Should I not do it? What if I don't do it? What will happen if I do it? And that's just there. And once you, that's such a fine line. Once you step out of it, then such a huge world that you come in contact with. And there's so much to achieve and go and get. And it gets so much easier. Very nicely said, guys. I'm so honored to have, you know, got such a diversified, you know, set of women who are working together. And working this beautiful venture called Happy People and Company. So to my viewers, I would like to say that we will be tagging Happy People and Company down below in the description box. Do go and check out the work that you're doing. Do go out, go and, you know, maybe sign up for the workshops if you'd like to, because they are doing some amazing job out there. And you're definitely going to feel a lot of happiness if you join with them. Thank you, Shreya, Pehel and Tanvi for coming here on KYE Talks and sharing about your journey.
Thank you, Sonal. It was a pleasure.
Thank you. Thank you, Sonal.
Thank you so much for having us, Sonal.
Wonderful.